I hope the people in Jagholm are safe since we left.
Jagholm? So I was right. You really do come from a backwater village.
No, actually, we come from Elan.
That's even more remote!
Thank you.
Darian, aren't those Arcolyte weapons?
Yes. I figured the Arcolytes would try and disrupt the Hurelsor trade routes soon.
We have to stay alert. The area is more dangerous than ever now.
This kind of feels like deja vu.
Let's talk to the merchants and see if we can travel with them to Avaris.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, here we are. Ask away.
Let's start from the beginning. Who exactly are you?
Isaura Samaresius Firebrand, fourth of the name. Former heir to the House of Firebrand, laureate emeritus of the Imperial School of Wizardry. Wandering outcast, apprentice cipher, and the only known survivor of the corrosion. And the only person on Herion capable of finding the silver-haired goddess.
Is that all?
Apart from being the world's most knowledgeable man on the corrosion, my other speciality is losing things.
Losing things?
I have lost everything that can be lost by a man. Lost an arm? Check. Legs? Check. A loved one? Check. My status and power, check. The ability to cast magic, check.
Magic? How?
Lost my keys, once, check. This pendant here, I lost it once. My pants, my mind, my lunch. Check, check, and check. See? I am an expert on loss.
You haven't lost your life.
I lost what was my life. That's close enough.
Tell us more about the one you call the Silver-Haired Goddess.
The Silver-Haired Goddess? She's on Avaris, I can tell you that much. Somewhere near Twisted Peak, actually. There's a clockwork field there, more fearsome than any other. She lives there.
Will she help us?
If she's truly a goddess, then she will. But we're not even sure she is.
I believe she will listen to us, but helping us? Oh, that's another thing.
Why not? She cured you.
Yes, and you know the funniest thing about that? I didn't even want to be saved anymore.
What?
I was actually on the ground begging for somebody, anybody, to kill me. I had given up. And, whoop, here she comes out of nowhere, turns me on my back, and lays her hands on me. few seconds later, I was cured.
Describe her.
Small, apologetic, sad. There was something otherworldly about her. I suppose that's natural for a goddess, but it might have been because my vision was blurry. Sorry, that's all I can remember.
Did she use some form of magic?
I don't know. What else could it be?
If it's a form of magic, I can learn it.
So if something happens to the silver-haired goddess, you can take her place?
I'm not joking. What if she refuses to help us? What if she dies? Is she even a goddess? What if she loses her power at some point? We must be prepared for every possibility.
I see your point. So what?
The moment has come for you to decide if we part ways or if I stay with you. I can give you the rep mag and draw you a map of the silver-haired goddess's location. So you won't have to keep me around if you don't want me here, which is something I'd understand.
Of course you're coming with us. What are you talking about? You can hold your own in a fight and you know more about the corrosion than anyone else. What do you think, Celine?
I agree. Your expertise is invaluable. We would be grateful to have you with us.
Well, you didn't have to go so far. But I'm grateful that you would let me stay.
I have one last question. Do you know if the one you called the silver-haired goddess was corroded when you saw her?
As I said, my vision was blurry. If she was, I didn't see it.
Thank you. I need some time to think about all this.
Do you mean sleep?
Exactly.
It is time.
Yes, oh, exactly. It's about time you released me. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Hey, he's coming for us!
You. Why did you capture us? Why are you keeping us here? I have a family, and Solna. And they're probably hungry, waiting for me. They need me. Let me go. I beg of you.
You two will answer my questions, and you will not lie. Two children. One of them beats the other in an act of pure cruelty before your very eyes. Do you chastise the perpetrator or comfort the victim?
I'd rather comfort the beaten child than punish the one who misbehaved. Our duty is to protect the innocent. Always.
And you?
I'd get the crying one a stick and we'd go and beat up the little twerp together. Consolation and revenge. Two birds, one stone. Pure genius, I know.
You have to choose.
Nah, man, I don't. I don't need to choose either if I can find my own solutions.
I pray to Krator, okay? I'm Arcadian. We're big on Argolite technology. So, the God of Lightning. It seemed like a good idea. Everyone thought it was a good idea. I also pray to Ansel from time to time.
Whoa, sounds like lip service, man.
How the hell would you know?
And you?
I don't know, man. I mean, why should I pray to the gods in the first place? Before your flunkies got to me, I was going to war. Do you know how many years they've been at it? A lot of years. I'll probably die out there, okay? Just like the rest. The gods didn't raise a finger for them, and they won't raise a finger for me. So why should I pray to them? Nothing. I don't know, to be rich? Won't happen anytime soon. It's a stupid question.
You. I had big dreams once. Now I just want my family to be safe. I don't even know what happened to them since you brought me here. I'll do anything you ask, if you let me go back to them. Anything. Hey, so you picked me. Did I pass the test? Are you releasing me? What? What do you intend to do? Stop this. I have a family waiting for me on the outside. I have two daughters. One of them is five. They're alone out there. They need me. Don't do this. I'll do it. Don't do this. No. No. Stop it, please. No.
Let's get to work.